What I was saying is welcoming you people. Thank you for coming over and listening to this old man's desire to be a speaker. And I don't know what I'm speaking about, but I have a topic. I have a theme which I'm going to convey to you. And my main theme, as you said, what I would like to be specializing in is lifelong contentment. I have not learned this thing from any book, from any video, from any elderly person. This is all my own life experience. That's why I think I will be good at it if I start speaking in chapters and give you the complete picture. When I say happiness, you may start wondering what he means by happiness. You may start looking at my face. Does this guy look happy? And what was his life? How did he lead his life? Was it really eventful? Did he achieve something? Is he at a higher station than he started? Or he is just a person, a hermit who can sleep on a footpath, who doesn't care if he has new shoes. Those people are always also happy. Homeless people are also happy. Don't be afraid. I'm not taking you there. I'm not going to brainwash you. I'm not going to make you a drug addict. Even a drug addict is happy when they are on the high. Then God forbid when they go low, then nobody's there to help them. So my formula will not take you high or low. It will be in between, logical, balanced, feet on the ground, and also your head in the sky. It's a different thing. I don't know how to explain it to you. Let me continue. Maybe one day you will grasp what I'm trying to say. When you are in that state of mind where you are relaxed and you are contented, many things have gone into making you into that frame of mind. First of all, you will have to face a lot of hardships. Some of you may have already done that, or maybe you are still in that phase of hardship where you want to get out of, not only from that situation, you are so fed up that maybe you want to get out of this world itself. That's the depression part, that which the word itself should not be in your dictionary. What has depression to do with you? I mean, people are happy, unhappy doesn't mean they are depressed. You cannot be happy, even I cannot guarantee you that you will be happy each second of your life, because life is like that. If you are not unhappy, how will you appreciate your happiness? How will you have a reference point how happy you are? Happiness is valuing what you have, not desiring what you don't have. How can you miss something which you don't have? How can you desire for a better, whatever equipment, whatever accommodation, whatever materialistic thing you have, how do you desire that you could get a better one than that? Or if you see somebody using something which is a new model, or take an example of a mobile phone. Nowadays, everybody must have a mobile phone in their hand. My neighbor, he has a better phone than me. My colleague has a better iPhone. Maybe he has an iPhone. I don't even know how to use an iPhone. I am a guy who has a 2.4 Android, the lowest category of mobile phone. I am very happy with it. The purpose of a mobile phone is to convey messages to me, or a call should come, it should not be dropped. I am very happy with it. I am not going to see any videos in it. Main purpose is my communication should continue. I should be in touch. I am not going to go to Facebook with that. I don't need all that social media thing. In fact, if you are a person who is happy chatting, tweeting, going on Facebook, then you are a virtual person. You are not alive. Living people need living interaction, they need face to face, they have to talk to people, they need company. They become lonely if there is nobody surrounding them. Okay, what I'm leading you is that you should have friends, you should have people, your family, you should have a gathering all the time. Loneliness leads you to a situation which you should avoid. I'll tell you what that situation is. You must have heard of the saying that empty vessels make the most noise. When you are alone, your mind is empty, bad thoughts may come into it. It's like a radio or a TV. You have to tune your channel. Which channel do you want to beam to? Which channel do you want to interact with? If you leave your tuning open, any bad channel can also come in and they will mislead you. When you are alone, many bad thoughts like suicide, like hate, like hatred, like not liking somebody, like taking a revenge, those things are bad for you. Once people are there, they interrupt your thoughts, so you don't have time to think of bad things. People are there, they interrupt your thoughts. Remember, I'm stressing it again, it's good for you. But how are they interrupting? By what are they interrupting? Are they giving you better thoughts than you have? Or are they also leading you to the bad parts? Maybe they're telling you to come with them. Let's go out. Let's have a joyride. Let's go to the beach. Let's make fun of other people. Let's make somebody a scapegoat and start laughing at him. Or let's go and drink. Let's get drunk. Let's go for that bar where they sell drugs under the counter. If that's the way they are going to make you happy, please, better off you avoid that company, even if it is your relatives. Remember, worst things happen in a house. As they say, you are more insecure in a house, in your own home. You could slip in the bathtub. You could have accidents, you could burn your fingers. It doesn't mean you are at home, you are safe. Same way if you are with your friends, your relatives, the worst bad things done to people are by their relatives. So don't blindly trust anybody. It's your life, it's your body, it's your mental peace. Give peace to others, but don't accept disturbance or tension from other people. Keep a safe distance. Try to tell them where their liberty, their freedom stops and where your rights start. I'll tell you a small joke before I end. It is a joke, but it's very practical. It gives you the example I'm trying to convey. A new nation got independent. So everybody was dancing and music and drinking and waving their hands. So one of the person by mistake accidentally hit the nose of the other guy. So the other guy stopped him. He said, look what you are doing. Why did you hit my nose? This guy says, you know, it's our freedom. The country is free. So we are free. So that's why I'm dancing and all. So he told this guy, listen, my friend, your freedom stops where my nose begins. So there is a boundary. Don't let people trample you. Don't let people overcome your things. Don't let people quieten you down and start shouting at you and telling their problems to you. There are people like that. They will not let you speak. Only they want to speak and tell their story. Whatever you want to say, convey, they will interrupt you and put in their loud-voiced conversation. Those are the people to avoid. They are not good for you. What do you get my drift? Where am I trying to take you away? You have a decision. Don't be so hungry, so lonely that whichever person is next to you is the best company you can get. Don't be so I mean, don't throw yourself at somebody that you cannot survive without them. Even in love, even in the opposite sex, there is also your own personality, your own respect. Both of you should respect each other's privacy also. There are times even in marriage when husband and wife need to be secluded. They want to be away from each other. The best love in marriage is that when the husband or wife are separated for some time, either the wife goes to their country or the husband goes, meet their relatives, come back, meet again. They miss each other. They remember that the life together was better than being separated. It brings it up value. But living together all the time with the same face, same voice, it becomes irritating. So don't lose your respect. Live together, love each other, but respect each other also. Because your wife is not there just for the cooking and the cleaning. She's there, she is known as your better half. She's known as your life companion. Not just to be there to wash your clothes. She is there to guide you. Maybe you will make a mistake. Any place where there is no woman's touch, it's very, very dreary. Brash. Men don't know how to live, I'll be honest with you. It's a woman's touch which gives you that tenderness, that softness. So when you are with your wife, respect each other, take advice from her. They are better money managers than men. It's a challenge. You can take me to court on that. I'll prove you that women are better money managers than men. They know how to save. They don't overspend. They are the people who sacrifice when their children are growing. They have desires also. They may also like some expensive stuff, but they don't buy it. They only think that whatever I have is for my children. Husbands, men, they may not do it. They may think they can earn that, as they are dreamers. I think I'll end this now because my thoughts are going away with this.